Hi, my name is Carlina Müller. I'm a Food for Life instructor with the Physicians Committee for Responsible Medicine, and I trained with them 5 years ago. I was really excited to have found them because I had health problems and especially weight problems all my life. And when I found whole food plant-based eating in 2011, I talked to all my friends and family, and they were not necessarily ready to hear me. So with having the training, I had the qualification to just do cooking classes for anyone who wanted to come. I'm so excited I get to collaborate with Lifestyle Docs, that they provide me the platform so I can teach people how to make wonderful healthy food and support you on your journey. While I'm happy to eat oatmeal every day, my husband really likes variety. One of the meals we rotate through is tofu scramble. So the base is tofu, you start with a firm tofu, and then add vegetables. You basically can add any softish cooking vegetable. We start with onions and garlic, and then mushrooms, we add the bell pepper, and then at the end we add turmeric for yellow color, and cumin and black pepper for taste. Here we start with the onion. I cut it in half. And now I will cut a little bit at an angle, but not all the way through, so all the onion leaves are kept together at the end. Don't cut yourself. So with this, the onion is still one onion. And now you basically cut along the upper part of your fingers here and chop it. Now on the back slope here, the knife starts sliding towards me. I might do a cut or two, and now I have a flat top surface again. And then I put it on the side, and you can chop the end off. And there's basically no waste. For the garlic clove, again, I cut it in half, so you have a flat, stable surface. And now I place the two halves together like this. It works in most cases that they fit nicely together, and I can cut both halves simultaneously. I will slice them really thinly. And remember to tuck your thumb in. I use the thumb to push a little bit, but I have it behind the fingers. And then at the end, again, I flip the clove so I have a flat, stable surface. And then I can cut to the end. So if you like garlic slices, you're all good. But if I want to have it finer chopped, now I just chop with a knife. Again, make sure your fingers are all above the blade of the knife. There you go, garlic is chopped. We often add a lot of vegetables, especially mushrooms, and they tend to release a little bit more water. You don't want to have your tofu scramble wet, right? It's supposed to be something you can fill in a tortilla or eat on bread or however you do it. So I tend to press the tofu. What I found, how I can do it very easily without a tofu press, I put it between two cutting boards. It works really well if you have a larger and a smaller one. So let's see. I start in the center and I just chop it up a bit. And you see it scrambles very nicely at the same time. And now I put the cutting board over it. And if there is liquid to be released, it will come out now. See? The heat is on and the pan is preheating. So now I'm adding the onions. You want to start with the onions alone first. You notice I didn't have any oil in the pan, and yet it makes that sizzling noise. I actually add the lid for a moment and let everything heat up for a bit. Let's see how that looks. It's that scent starts to develop. Let's give this a little bit more. Here for the tofu scramble, you want to get the onions translucent and not really brown. So we want to give them enough time to cook all the way through. You see, I'm using a stainless steel pan. I found that to be the easiest to saute without oil. Have a little bit of water at your hand, so if things overheat too much, you can quickly quench it. You can also see how the onions are sweating and water starts to evaporate, so as they get drier, then they start to heat up more. When you cut onions, it's actually okay to let them sit for a while and at the cut surfaces, a reaction happens that develops cancer-fighting components. So it's totally okay to cut your onions hours before. If you want to cut in the evening for the next morning, just put them in the refrigerator. And in the morning you're good to go really quick. So you can have all the vegetables prepared and then just prepare the tofu scramble quickly in the morning. So here we have now browning happening. So I add the garlic for just a moment. I will also add a splash of water. You don't want to burn the garlic. And since my pan is so hot, I now add the mushrooms. And cover it with the lid for a moment. Mushrooms still need to cook just a moment more. You want to have them a little softer. Next, after these mushrooms are cooked enough, we'll add the bell pepper. Actually, you see now they're starting to soften, so it's time to add bell peppers. And cook these for a moment. Now you can see how it's sweating even a bit more, so you can see how it draws out the moisture. how liquid is forming. Don't want to overcook the mushrooms because then they really release liquid. And when we think that the vegetables are soft enough, then we will add the tofu. Maybe one more moment. There you go. That looks pretty good. You see the colors are still really vibrant. So make sure the tofu is all scrambled. And I can scramble also a bit more inside the pan. Now comes the fun part. We get to add color. I add the turmeric. And cumin for flavor. You could mix it up with different varieties of spices. Like if you use rather zucchini and tomatoes, you could use thyme and oregano. Since I'm using turmeric, I'm also using black pepper because that combination provides us with the health benefits. And everything gets mixed together. And turn up the heat a bit. Making sure that beautiful yellow gets everywhere. I hope you are ready to eat after this. It looks so good and you don't get to smell it, but it smells really good. As soon as the lid gets hot, and now everything is hot through, let's stir it one more time. There we are, tofu scramble is finished. All right, are we ready to eat? I heated two tortillas, so let's fill in some of this tofu scramble. Want to have a generous portion. It has the fluffiness and definitely smells really lovely. I want to get mushrooms and everything. And then we have some salsa here, some salsa fresca. So that might be a nice addition. Has some jalapenos, tomatoes, onions, and banana peppers. And then lime juice. And it's always good to have a little bit more green, so we have a little bit more cilantro here. Let's do one more sprig. And now you get to roll it up, tuck in the end, and bon appetit. If you would like to keep up with what I'm doing, you can find me on Facebook at Carlina's Plant Kitchen. And also look for events at lifestyledocs.com. Until next time.